Hello everyone, welcome to another video. In this video we will discuss an important topic: how to create a Dataverse table within 5 minutes by connecting with your SharePoint list. Microsoft has enabled so many new features in Microsoft Power Apps and Power Platform so that you can manage your work, day-to-day work, easily. So today we'll discuss how to create Dataverse table by connecting with SharePoint list with a quick way. So to do that, you have to go to table and go to mac.powerapps.com and create a new table. When you click on create a new table and choose create new table option, it will display the data workspace where you can select one option to create a table. Here you will find an option called as import a SharePoint list. By clicking this import a SharePoint list, it will ask you to connect your SharePoint list using this URL. You have to provide your SharePoint URL here in this first text box. Then it will connect and display all recent sites that you have created. Okay. Then it will list out all the list that is created inside a SharePoint site. So let us wait for some seconds. It is activating the page. Now this feature is in preview, but very soon it will be globally available. Now here you have to provide your SharePoint URL. Okay, where is your SharePoint URL? You can navigate to the SharePoint URL, or if you are having any recent sites you have navigated, it will display here. My SharePoint URL I can copy from the SharePoint, or I can copy from the recent URL. So let me navigate to my SharePoint list. I'll go to mac.powerapps.com and navigate to my SharePoint application. So when I click this app switcher here on the top left corner, app launcher, then here I can see my SharePoint. When I click my SharePoint app, I have the URL, SharePoint URL display here. So up2.com, this is my host URL of my SharePoint app. So I'll go here in the Creatable option and give the SharePoint URL here and click connect. When I'll click connect, it will display all the sites that are part of the site available. But if you give the home address of your SharePoint, it will display the recent sites. But if you want to have any specific sites where your list components are available, you can give that website by navigating to your list. So let me go to the SharePoint and navigate to a list. I'll go to the my list, and this is the site, for example, future properties, and it will land to the future property site. So I'll copy this entire site address and put it here, and once we connect, the site will be reflected here. And when I click this, all the list created inside the site that I have selected will display here. Let's say I want to create the future feedback table, which is connected to future feedback list. So I can click on import. When I click on import, automatically the SharePoint table will be imported here and it will display in the data workspace. Okay, it is now moving and recreating the schema matching with the SharePoint list called as feedback, future feedback, and create a new table inside our Dataverse, which is done by AI with a couple of seconds, right? Now, once it is done, you can click to verify, you can view data, you can check properties. Okay. If you click on the check properties, you can see what name it is created, what is the primary column that is defined, right? And if you click on view data, if there is any data available, that will display here. So these are the data already there. That's why the data is already created in Dataverse. Now click on save and exit. Now when you click on save and exit, the table is created with all data imported from SharePoint list inside your Dataverse. Now you can use that data table, Dataverse table whose name is future feedbacks, in any Power Apps that you want to create. Let's say I want to create a app with this newly table created that is imported from SharePoint. Then what I can do, I can go to the table section and create a new app out of the table so that I can manage the data available in this table. It's not a virtual table, it is a standard table that is created, which is nothing but a table that is created by importing all the data from the SharePoint list immediately with a couple of seconds, right? So this is a feature integrated in our Power Platform ecosystem, which makes us easy to import any list available in our SharePoint site inside Dataverse. Okay. Now if you go to here, we'll find the table that is created. If you search feed, you'll see all the, this is the table that is created and it is standard type. Now if you open this, you'll see the properties and the columns that is created. If you click on columns, you'll see these are the columns that is created with matching columns available in the SharePoint. Let's create a new app with this entity. I can go to the table and click on new app so that it will create an app. Let's say you can create a canvas app. If you use this create an app, it will create a canvas app. But if you want to create a model driven app, you can use this entity as a sitemap link so that it will work, right? So if you don't know that how an entity is exposed as a model driven app, then you can watch my other videos or you can join live training. But this is how you can import the table from SharePoint list immediately in Dataverse with a couple of seconds, and with data also, that is very important. And AI will do all the necessary schema creation, column creation, okay, everything. Understood? So hope you understand how it is done with a quick timing from SharePoint to Dataverse using the AI feature. Thank you everyone watching this video. See you next time. Bye.